Good morning, students. Today we'll see Bayat Sobatla. In 1820, Christian Oyster stated that when a magnetic needle is placed near a current carrying conductor, the magnetic needle got deflected. That means when current is passed through a conductor, a magnetic field is produced around it. Right? He also experimented that when the direction of the current of flow was changed, the deflection in the magnetic needle also changed. Then only we got the term electromagnetism. Later on, Bayat and Sobat worked on this principle and they wanted to find the magnitude of the field produced at a point near the conductor, right? If this is the current carrying conductor, magnetic field will be produced around this conductor, and so they wanted to find the value of the magnetic field at a point P, which is at a distance of R from the current carrying conductor. For that, they consider a loop of wire for which a potential was applied, and so the current flowing through it was I. They also considered a small elemental length DL, and they wanted to find the magnetic field at this point P, and this point P is at a distance of R. And unit vector of R is the direction of R. So value of dB was found. Also, they considered that the line element DL and the unit vector R made an angle theta between them. So the magnitude of magnetic field dB at a point P at a distance R from a small elemental length DL taken on the conductor carrying current varies as the magnetic field is dB and it varies as the current. dB is directly proportional to the strength of the current I. It is also directly proportional to the magnitude of a length element. So, if we take the length to be larger, dB is also going to be larger. It is also directly proportional to the sine of the angle between R and DL. dB is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the point and the length element DL. That means, as the distance R increases, dB is going to decrease, right? If the point is nearer to the current carrying conductor, dB will be larger, and if it is away, the dB, that is the magnitude of the magnetic field, will be lesser. And so it could be written as dB is proportional to I DL sine theta divided by R squared, that is square of the distance, that is R squared. So dB is proportional to I DL sine theta divided by R squared. And this proportionality constant could be written as dB is equal to K I DL sine theta by R squared. But what is K? K is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi in SI units. So in vector notation, we can write that dB is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi IDL cross R vector divided by R square. dB is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi IDL is same as IDL, and sine theta dB is considered to be perpendicular to DL and R. In vector notation, dB could be written as mu 0 by 4 pi IDL cross R vector divided by R square. Why do we write this dl cross r unit vector. That is, it is said that the magnitude of the magnetic field is perpendicular to dl and also unit vector r, right? Thanks for watching.